Welcome back from Cloud Computing in AWS. And today we are going to look to the class of the Cloud Foundation. And this is going to be the first lesson to prepare you for the AWS Certified Cloud Practitioner. I am Dr. Basil Magable, a certified AWS instructor and educator, and I would like to help you to get the AWS certificate, which is the first step to basically build your career in the AWS cloud. The course prerequisite, we expect you to have a generic IT knowledge, a generic IT technical knowledge and business knowledge, and we prefer if you know a bit about the cloud computing concepts, working knowledge of a cloud computing and distributed system, and you are familiar with general networking concepts and the multi-tier architecture. But if you don't worry, because in this class, I'm going to help you to be certified and to build in the cloud, because I help thousands of students to be certified, and many of my students, they are working currently in AWS and many other organizations. If you like this type of content, guys, feel free to subscribe and leave comment down below and share this video to support my channel and to support me personally to produce more content. The course is divided into 10 lessons. We will look to the cloud concepts, then we will look to the billing and then to the global infrastructure, and then we will look to the AWS cloud security and the responsibility and the shared responsibility model of AWS cloud computing. Then we will look to the networking and content delivery. Normally, this is the VPC. And I can tell you guys from my personal experience, if you understand a VPC, you will be able to pass the cloud practitioner very easily. Then we will study compute services, how we can build an EC2 machine, how we can build a Lambda function or Elastic Beanstalk, or build any compute service available to us like Elastic Container Service in the cloud. Then we will look to the storage service for SC3 and databases like MySQL in RDS. And then we will look to the well-architected framework by AWS and the automatic scaling and monitoring. So this course will help you to prepare for the cloud practitioner. Now, after you get the AWS cloud practitioner exam, you will be able to do the developer exam and the operation and the architect exam. And the solution architect is one of the most distinguished certificates that you can get in the industry. It has the highest value now in the industry. So I recommend for you to target and to aim to get the solution architect certificate. Now, these are information about the exam and the AWS certificate. So feel free to go to these links and check. And there is also a sample exam, a question and the preparation guide. As well, I will make another lesson for you later on to prepare for the exam and how we can do the exam strategy. Now let us look to the first lesson, which is the cloud concepts overview of cloud foundation. In this lesson, we will know what is a cloud computing and basically on-demand delivery of these IT resources, including compute power, database storage, and IT resources in a pay-as-you-go pricing model. And the concept here is very easy to understand because this is very similar to the utility model that we all use. If we want a gas heating for our houses, we go and make a subscription for a gas provider. If we want an internet connection to your home, you go and you make a subscription, which is a pay-as-you-go model, to an internet service provider. In the same way, we think now in the cloud computing to deliver those IT resources, and you can lease them from a cloud provider like AWS, so you can build in the cloud and you can use them to launch your product and services. So cloud computing, guys, help us to think about our infrastructure as a component of software that we can building them together as a building blocks, instead of thinking about our infrastructure as a hardware. Why hardware is not the optimal solution here? In the traditional computing model, when we deal with infrastructure as a hardware, we need to have a space, a staff, physical security, planning, capital expenditure, and we have all the time a long hardware procurement cycle. If we want to order a server today, you need to wait for a few weeks or months for the server to arrive to your data center. And this will require you to have to provision and to estimate your capacity and you will guess that capacity. And most of the time, our guess is not correct. So maybe we order one server, but we find our product is very successful, so we need to order another one. Or maybe we order two servers, but actually our demand shows us that we only need one server to run the product. Because for a simple reason, there is no high demand coming to the server. There are three main cloud service models. And these service models, we start with the one which has the least control over IT resources, or what we call software as a service. In this kind of services, we are provided with the software out of the box with the complete product, and we use it without configuring it, without making any adjustment to it, or without any installation or settings. The next one is the platform as a service. In the platform as a service, this will reduce the need for us to manage the underlying infrastructure, but we think mainly about configuring the library and the deployment and the management of our application. So we don't have ability to configure the operating system or configure the CPU and the RAM in these kind of services. We only can configure the deployment model. And similar to what we will see later on in Amazon Relational Database Service and AWS Elastic Beanstalk. The third model, which is infrastructure as a service. In infrastructure as a service, we have more control over the IT resources. And this gives us more control over the cloud infrastructure, so we can build our own virtual machine, build those cloud services from those building a block, and we have access to networking and to compute and to storage. And normally, IaaS provide us with the highest level of flexibility and management to control over our IT resources. And it is the most similar existing IT resources that many IT departments use it today. A good example of infrastructure as a service is Amazon EC2. You will be able to build in the cloud infrastructure and to configure the operating system that you need, the number of CPUs, so you can assign a CPU 2, a RAM I want 2, and operating system I want Linux, and so on. Now, when a customer comes to you and he said, I heard from my friend that there is something called the cloud computing, and this is saving him a lot of money, because he migrates his business to the cloud. Now, there is a three main deployment model in cloud computing. The first one is called all in the cloud, which means we move everything completely and everything will be fully deployed in the cloud without having anything left on premise data center. The second one is to have a private cloud. And this is a private cloud where we can deploy resources on premises using those virtualization and resource management tools. And sometimes those private cloud, they will be using AWS services in those private on-premise data center, like USGov, for example. There is an AWS USGov, which is a private cloud, which means you need to be authorized and authenticated to access the USGov. And there is the hybrid cloud, which is a mix between all in the cloud and on-premise data center. So you will have part of your resources in the cloud and other part of your resources on-premise. Normally, when you have your data, for example, you want to keep your data on-premise and you have your cloud infrastructure speaking with those back-end data or data model in your on-premise data center from the cloud. Now, cloud computing gives us its six main advantages. And the first one, as you know now, we trade capital expense for variable expense. Because of the cloud computing, guys, we don't need to worry about the cost associated with building a data center from scratch, but now we can, in a pay-as-you-go model, we can lease those resources from AWS, and we will start building our product and services, and we have to pay a monthly bill. And there is a massive economy of scale, which means we have a large access. When we use cloud computing, we can have a lower variable cost than you can get when you have your own data center. Because usage from hundreds of thousands of customers is aggregated in the cloud, enable AWS to achieve a higher economies of scale, which translates into lower pay as you go price model for the end customer. The third one is to stop guessing capacity. So we don't have now, once we use AWS Cloud, we are going to have an autoscaler, and that autoscaler will look to our infrastructure and it will adjust that capacity based on the demand. It will add or remove resources based on the actual demand. So we won't have an overestimated server capacity. We order one server, but we find we need three. Or we order three servers and we find that we need only two. And we can increase the speed and agility. And we can stop spending money on running and maintaining data center. And we can go global in minutes. So AWS Cloud Computing can enable us to increase the time to market. When we build and focus on building a product, we can release it very quickly and fastly to the cloud or to the customer, and we stop spending money on the long running cost of data center, and we can go global in minutes. And you will see later on, anything we do in the AWS Management Console, even the labs we do together, they are going to be available for you to share with your friends in another country. So any product you build in AWS, you will be able to make it globally available in a few minutes. So what is AWS? AWS is a secure cloud platform that offers a broad set of global cloud-based products. It gives us an on-demand access to the compute, storage, network, database, and other IT resources that you might need for your project and the tools to manage them, so you can immediately provision and launch AWS resources, and those resources are ready for you to use in minutes. And this basically give you the ability to build your product from those wide range and broad set of AWS services as a building blocks. After you will finish my Cloud Foundation class, you will be able to build similar architecture. You will be able to build inside AWS Cloud. You will be designing your own VPC. And inside this VPC, you will create your own subnet. And then you will launch a web server. And you will launch and build an RDS for MySQL. And then you will enable the web server to speak with the RDS. And you will run your web server behind the load balancer and autoscaler, which make your software highly available, highly scalable, and highly secure as well by adding an extra layer of security using what we call security group. And this is what I will teach you in lesson 4 of this class. Mainly in the Cloud Foundation, we focus in 4 categories of the foundation or the core services of AWS. We focus on the network services, which are the VPC. We focus also in the compute services, which are the Amazon EC2, which are the virtual machine. And we focus on the database services, like building an RDS or DynamoDB, like MySQL server. And then we will focus on the storage, like Amazon Simple Storage Service, which is basically a service that we use to store files and the objects in the cloud or archives. So in the foundation, you need to worry only about these core services. And later on in the solution architect, you will learn more about those services in the future. So as I said, in the cloud foundation, we will look to compute services, storage services, management, database, cost management services like cost and usage report, AWS budget, AWS cost explorer. And then we'll look to networking and content delivery like Amazon VPC, Amazon Route 53, and Amazon CloudFront and Elastic Load Balancing. With security and identity, we look to AWS IAM, Amazon Cognito, AWS Shell, AWS Artifacts, and AWS KMS. So what we can take from this lesson? We managed to define different types of cloud computing models, all in the cloud, hybrid cloud, and the private cloud. We also recognize the main AWS services or the core services, which are the networking, storage, database, and compute. And we describe 6 advantages of cloud computing. And then we look to the core AWS services that we are going to study in this class. Thank you for seeing this video and see you in the lesson 2, which is the cloud economics and billing.